founding member in guitar and vocals. Then Martin Allcock, Squeezy Thing and Other Goodies, Dave Pegg on the bass guitar, and on loan from Tull, Doane Perry at the drums. But first, Ric Sanders, nearly the Fairport Convention. Hooray!
Thank you. Thanks very much. A tune there from California, from Paul Horn, from Ireland, from Tullochacolaran, and from the outer asteroid belt from Ric Sanders. In celebration of Irving Berlin's 100th birthday, which occurred just a couple of weeks ago, for those of you who didn't send him a card, we'd like to play you now our interpretation of one of the, surely one of the finest tunes ever written in America. This was by Duke Ellington. Well, we'd like to turn the clock back a bit now and play a little tune from the Paul McCartney of his generation, Johann Sebastian Bach. This is our version of his double violin concerto, and if you think that's a good trick for one fiddle player to be both Pinker Zukerman and Isaac Pellman, I have to be Riccardo Muti and the Philadelphia Orchestra on this one. So, stretch your imaginations, here we go. Thank you. Sorry, a little bit puzzled, are we? We like to think we're playing music for the late 80s, but we also like to think that some of the younger people in the audience might enjoy it as well. As Ian said when he called us on, we are Ric Sanders and Simon Nicol, and we're members of Fairport Convention, who unfortunately couldn't be with you this evening. But as there's a degree of cross-fertilisation, nay, osmosis between ourselves and Jeff Rotel, we've managed to persuade some of the old lags to come out and add their undoubted musical talent and good looks to what we're up to. This is a song about being in the army and discovering all too late that you're in fact, by nature, a conscientious objector, which makes you, in army terms, a deserter. I stand in a land that isn't my home, far from the country that I know is home. I was sent here by government and armed by the king, and I'm told I must kill men in order to bring peace to a foreign land. There he lies on a land that isn't his own, grey of a country he once called his home. He was sent here by government and might not agree, and if someone must kill him, God, why is it me? To bring peace to a foreign land. Don't despise the deserter. Don't despise the deserter who ran from the war. Don't despise the deserter. Don't despise the deserter who ran from the war. Down to dragon, away from the wild. The rifles to the left of me started a fire. It's riddled with bullets, I was smothered in blood, and I can't see how murdering somebody could bring peace. Don't despise the deserter. Don't despise the deserter who ran from the war. Don't despise the deserter. Don't despise the deserter who ran from. Thank you. fighting, threw down my gun. I ran with the moon, and I slept by the sun. Rested by government, charged by the king to be shot, cause I can't kill in order to bring peace to a fallen land. Don't despise the deserter, don't despise the deserter who ran from the war. Don't despise the deserter, don't despise the deserter who ran from the war.
Dave Pegg on the bass, Martin Allcock on the squeezy thing and assorted guitars, and our special guest, Doane Perry, who has been helping us out on this tour, getting sweaty twice a night, just so he can get those negatives back. Anyway, this is a set of four tunes we started playing on an American tour in 1970. They're called Dirty Linen, and tonight may be the night we play them correctly from start to finish. Keep your fingers crossed. I know it sounds like I've got mine crossed. We'll be right back. Just coming, tuning. If you're a bit confused about who Fairport Convention might be, and you want to resolve this mystery from our tangled past, the best clue to give you is to tell you that the next song, Reynard the Fox, is available on In Real Time on Island Records. In real time. That's the plug over with. Here's the song. Takes delight in fox hunting by every degree. A story I will tell to you concerning of a fox. Near rice and woods and mountains high and over stony rocks. Already it is all a hearing of these hounds. This made him fall and prick up his ears and tread upon the ground. The things we hear subdue. Jethro Tull boys change into their stage costumes. Rick and I would like to thank them and the technicians for helping us out over the last couple of days. This is a song which started out in England, came to America, got knocked about a bit and polished up no end, and came back home as a traditional ballad called Matty Groves. Thanks for putting up with us. It's been nice raising the curtain for you. I hope you have a lovely evening.
And sleep with me tonight. Oh, I can't come home and I won't go home.
wife, and if I am Lord Arnold's wife, he is not at home. He is out in the far country, he's bringing a yearling home. And in her hurry to carry her news, she bent to breast and she ran. And when she came to the broad mill stream, she took off her shoes and she swam. He took a little sleep. When he awoke, Lord Arnold was standing by his feet, saying, how do you like my feather bed? How do you like my sheets? And how do you like my lady wife, who lies in your arms asleep? Oh, well, I like your feather bed better, I like your sheets. Best of all, I like your lady wife, who lies in my arms asleep.
Get up, get up!
Get up, get up, Lord Arnold cried. Get up as quick as you can, for it'll never be said in fair England that I slew a naked man. Oh, I can't get up, but I won't get up. I wouldn't get up for my life. For you have two long-beaten swords, while I not a pocket knife. It's true, I have two beaten swords, and they cost me deep in the purse. But you will love the better of them, and I will need the worse. And you will strike me the very first blow, strike it like a man. I will strike the very next blow, and I'll kill you if I can. He struck no more. Then he took his own dear wife and he sat her upon his knee and said, who do you like the best of us now? You dead Matty Groves or me? And perhaps broke his own dear wife, never heard her speak so free. I would rather one kiss from dead Matty's lips than you and I a finery. And that Lord Arnold, he jumped up and loudly did he bawl. He struck his wife right through the heart and he pinned her up to the wall.
Our special guest, the one and only Doane Perry.
Good night, thanks, have a good evening. Have fun, folks, and good night.